This is the Catholic Daily Mass Readings and Reflections for Friday of the 13th week in Ordinary Season. Today's first reading is from Genesis chapter 23 verses 1 to 4, 19 and chapter 24 verses 1 to 8. And the Gospel reading is from Matthew chapter 9 verses 9 to 13. Thanks for joining today's Mass Readings and Reflections. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing to this channel. Saint of the Day, Saints Marcellinus and Peter. Marcellinus and Peter were well known enough in the Church's memory to be included among the saints of the Roman canon. It is optional to mention their names in our current Eucharistic prayer one. Marcellinus was a priest and Peter was an exorcist, a person licensed by the Church to deal with the cases of demonic possession. They were beheaded during Emperor Diocletian's persecution. Based on their executioner's report, Pope Damasus penned an epitaph, and Constantine built a basilica over the crypt where they were buried in Rome. A first account of their death gave rise to a slew of legends. First reading from the book of Genesis, chapter 23, verses 1 to 4, 19, and chapter 24, verses 1 to 8. Sarah lived 127 years. These were the years of the life of Sarah. And as Sarah died at Kiriath Arba, that is Hebron, in the land of Canaan. And Abraham went in to mourn for Sarah and to weep for her. And Abraham rose up from before his dead and said to the Hittites, I am a stranger and a sojourner among you. Give me property among you for a burying place, that I may bury my dead out of my sight. After this, Abraham buried Sarah his wife in the cave of the field of Machpelah east of Mamre, in the land of Canaan. Now Abraham was old, well advanced in years, and the Lord had blessed Abraham in all things. And Abraham said to his servant, the oldest of his house, who had charge of all that he had, put your hand under my thigh, and I will make you swear by the Lord, the God of heaven and of the earth, that you will not take a wife for my son from the daughters of the Canaanites, among whom I dwell, but will go to my country and to my kindred and take a wife for my son Isaac. The servant said to him, perhaps the woman may not be willing to follow me to this land. Must I then take your son back to the land from which you came? Abraham said to him, see to it that you do not take my son back there. The Lord, the God of heaven, who took me from my father's house and from the land of my birth, and who spoke to me and swore to me, to your descendants, I will give this land, he will send his angel before you, and you shall take a wife for my son from there. But if the woman is not willing to follow you, then you will be free from this oath of mine. Only you must not take my son back there. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Response, Oriel Psalm. Your response, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Who can tell the mighty deeds of the Lord or proclaim all his praises? Your response, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Blessed are they who observe what is right, who do always what is just. Remember us, O Lord, as you favor your people. Your response, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Visit me with your saving help, that I may see the prosperity of your chosen ones. Rejoice in the joy of your people and glory with your inheritance. Your response, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Gospel Acclamation. Alleluia, Alleluia. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest, says the Lord. Alleluia, Alleluia. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew, chapter 9, verses 9 to 13. As Jesus passed on from there, he saw a man called Matthew sitting at the tax office. And he said to him, "Follow me." And he rose and followed him. And as he sat at table in the house, behold, many tax collectors and sinners came and sat down with Jesus and his disciples. And when the Pharisees saw this, they said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with the tax collectors and sinners?" But when he heard it, he said, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. Go and learn what this means. I desire mercy and not sacrifice. For I came not to call the righteous, but sinners." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Greetings, brothers and sisters. What would you say if someone asked you how you are doing? What is your response? "I am fine," or "I am doing fine," is a common response. Human nature will never allow us to think realistically. Our fallen nature tempts us to declare ourselves healthy and righteous. On the contrary, when we begin to practice humility, it will assist us in considering our true inner life, which is that of sick and sinners. In today's Gospel, we see that Jesus went to Matthew's house to eat. Since Matthew was a tax collector and his friends were tax collectors, there were a lot of tax collectors with him. Matthew left everything and followed Jesus. And in his joy, he organized the dinner. We also see Zacchaeus, another tax collector, who organized a dinner for Jesus in another Gospel. When the Pharisees saw so many tax collectors and sinners with Jesus, they began to make remarks. As a response to them, Jesus said, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. Go and learn what this means. I desire mercy and not sacrifice. For I came not to call the righteous, but sinners." When it says that he came not for the well and righteous, but for the sick and sinners, it means two things. First of all, it tells us that we are spiritually sick and sinful. Secondly, it tells us that if we cannot admit it and instead brag about how good and righteous we have effectively rejected Jesus, the divine physician, from our lives. We are basically saying, "Lord, I don't need you." It is also worth noting that Jesus did not care if he was seen with the sinners. He made no qualms about stating unequivocally that they were the ones he had come to save. As a result, we should not be embarrassed or afraid to admit that we are sinners who are spiritually sick and in desperate need of our Savior. Denying that fact is denying reality and the source of the lifelong healing we so desperately need. It is a denial of our need for Jesus Christ as a person. Do you require our Lord's help? Do you require daily cleansing, healing, and forgiveness? If answering yes wholeheartedly to that question is difficult for you, you may be struggling with the Pharisees' pride more than you realize. You will always need the divine physician's healing and forgiveness. No matter how holy you become, how deeply you pray, or how charitable you are, consider how much forgiveness you need right now in your life. Surprisingly, the more religious a person becomes, the more obvious their daily sins and need for forgiveness and healing become. If you are having trouble with this, spend some time examining your conscience. Look for ways to make it easier and more transparent. If you do, our Lord, the Divine Physician, will long to dine with you today and in the future. May God bless you all.